Well, a historic moment for space history happened earlier this week. India has become the first country to successfully land a spacecraft towards the South Pole of the Moon. The Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, exclaimed, "India is now on the Moon," after the spacecraft touched down. The Mooncraft took off from a launch pad in southern India on the 14th of July, taking over a month to get there after orbiting Earth several times. Inside the lander is a six-wheeled rover, which will roam the Moon's surface together to gather images and data. Scientists believe that the Moon's craters that are permanently in shadow may hold frozen water. If found in significant quantities, the ice water may allow future crew missions to set a base there, as it could be used to extract oxygen and fuel. Well, joining me now to discuss this very exciting issue is astronaut, space advocate and adventurer Per Wimmer. Now, Per, this is a very exciting time for space exploration, isn't it? Because there was the disappointment of a Russian probe crashing just last week into the Moon, and then this happens on the southern pole, which is quite difficult to get to, isn't it?
It is. It's actually the second time we're landing on the difficult spot.
Yes.
All the moon missions so far, including the Apollo program, etc., landed on the bright side of the moon,
yes,
not the dark side. There's only been one successful landing on the dark side before this mission, and that was the Chang'e 4 mission by the Chinese in 2019, which very cleverly and with the great help of NASA, ESA, landed on the dark side of the moon.
Mm.
So it ain't easy once you go into these outer part of the moon. And the South Pole certainly would qualify because part of the South Pole is dark.
Yeah. And why, given that it's difficult, why do people want to go to the South Pole? What's the attraction?
It is hugely attractive from a number of perspectives. First of all, scientifically,
about India, China, Russia and America trying to see who can do the first to do whatever. It's actually about resources and then using those resources. I think that's the important thing.
Yeah, and it's also about international collaboration.
Correct.
Interestingly enough, whilst on planet Earth, we have all sorts of political controversy, even wars. When it comes to space, we're actually collaborating.
Yeah.
Even the recent NASA rocket that went up had people from countries that are fighting wars at the moment. So it is really genuinely collaborating. And I think the Indians specifically here bring a lot to the table. I mean,
yeah,
this was a major feat they did. Not only would that rocket inspire a lot of Indian engineers and the young kids and stuff like that, but also India has a particularly strong strength in developing space cheaply. To put that probe on the surface costs less than $75 million, which is less than one of the blockbuster movies.
I mean, oh, goodness.
the Martian cost $108 million.
Yeah.
The Gravity cost $100 million.
So
they're really good in low cost.
Well, Per, you and I could talk about this all day, but I'm afraid I have other guests coming on. So thank you so much. Thanks to Per Wimmer.